everybody knows about three states of matter. The coldest one, solid, liquid, gas. Plasma is the fourth state of matter.
As you heat something up, it starts to change states of matter. So if you have an ice cube, you melt it, it turns into a liquid. That means that the atoms got a little bit looser, there's fewer connections between them. Then you boil it, turns into steam, and now it floats in the air, the atoms are even less connected. Heat it up even more, and that steam will turn into a plasma, which means that all of the separate atoms lost their electrons. The electrons are now free, and so now you have this electrified gas.
Plasmas are all around us. More than 99% of the visible universe is made out of plasma.
The sun is a giant ball of plasma, so we have plasma to thank for all of the energy that we have coming to our Earth. Galactic clusters, black holes.
The auroras, these fantastic light shows. Fire is a plasma, lightning is plasma.
Plasmas are important because we can engineer plasmas to do all sorts of things. Because they're electrified, that means we have new knobs to turn, electricity and magnetism, that we can use to direct plasmas, to accelerate plasmas. Once you start playing with these possibilities, you start to see how many different things we could be doing. There are just applications galore.
Plasmas themselves have been used widely in a lot of the steps that make up the 21st century. The microchip industry uses plasmas all the time in a lot of its processes.
Every time you've used anything electronic, it was made by a plasma. To lay down the nanoscale wires and connections across the computer chip.
We're also using plasmas in agriculture, medical applications, quantum information science, and sustainability.
And then, of course, the biggest application for plasmas is fusion, which is the future energy source where we rely on fusion reactions to produce energy, but that has to happen inside a plasma.
Without that knowledge, we can't really get to fusion energy in the grid. We need to understand plasmas in order to tackle those challenges. Here at the Princeton Plasma Physics Lab, we really are tackling the world's biggest science and technology challenges with the plasma expertise that we've built for 70 years.
The Princeton Plasma Physics Laboratory is a Department of Energy National Lab run by the U.S. government, funded by the U.S. government, but contracted by Princeton University. And so that means we have access to resources at Princeton that really help our research.
We learn new things about plasmas every day, both in our labs, our computational folks, our theorists. An ideal future is one in which plasmas and fusion are part of a day-to-day conversation in the US and in the world.
The more that we can make things more efficient and distribute this technology more broadly, so many different areas of technology stand to benefit from understanding plasma physics better.
We're working for the US and for humanity to develop new technologies and new solutions for the world.